So, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna use a soap that it's dedicated to a true wet saver, a constant supporter of wet saving, and he's from Greece, and this is the soap I'm gonna review. So, he's Hercules, as you can see. He's an active member and recently a moderator of the Men's Only Forum, a Greek wet saving forum here in Greece. And this is from TFS, from Italy, the personality range of saving soaps. And this is dedicated to him. The tab that comes with this soap is a cream color. Narrow at most, and it's a screw lid. It has 150 grams or 5 ounces of soap, and it's vegetable-based shaving soap with stearic acid, potassium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, coconut oil, and some the sticker is in here. Let me pause for a sec. So I had to do a quick confirmation. It's coconut oil based, but it has also golden jojoba oil. So not much ingredient list. It's very simple shaving soap, soft. So, as you can see, you can easily scoop out some of it to place it in your favorite bowl or anything that you want. I'm filling the hole because I'm OCD about this stuff. I believe it's filled. And the fragrance is lilac and licorice. Very sweet type of cologne scent. Not so sweet that it's a gourmand type of scent, but it's a very nice middle of strength scent. It's not so strong, it's not so light. It's just present. It's around 5 out of 10, and it really blended nicely. It's a very, very nice cologne type of scent of lilac and licorice. And I'm gonna use my Omega Proraso branded boar brush with a shorter loft for scrubbing. My Razorine raw brush, but today I'm gonna use for the second time a different blade. This is the Treet double-edged blade Durasharp. It's carbon steel, but it's a slim design carbon steel blade. If you hand your let me raise my face a little bit with the water. If someone hands to you this blade and he doesn't tell you that it's a carbon steel blade, you cannot tell the difference from a stainless steel blade. It's identical, but to my knowledge, carbon steel rusts easily, so you have to pay some attention to look for any rust spots, some drying between the uses, something like this, some care. So I'm gonna loading. You don't have any trouble loading this soap with any kind of brush because it's soft. It's an Italian style crepe. It's not a cream, it's not a soap, it's a crepe. It's very soft, but not so soft that you can put it in a tube and squeeze it out. I believe I have plenty of load here and some in the tub. And the price was very cheap. As you can see, I have 3 days of growth because I will explain later with my Razorine what is happening. And it's not Razorine's fault. I have the same problem with other razors also. And this 150 tubs of soap, it's very economical. It was 15 euros. And it comes with the matching aftershave that I didn't get it because I was tempted of an offer of some Alpa colognes that I really don't like. It was an offer for both of them, soap and aftershave, for 20 euros. Very good price, but there was also an offer of the soap and two Alpa colognes, the 378 and the Kovanlinka, but it was an body cologne, and the other, the 378, was an aftershave for 15 euros, the same price as the soap itself, and I was tempted purchase it. But I really didn't like the smell of it. That's 378. The other scent, it was somehow simpler. Very thick lather, as you can see, and I loaded very much my brush, so I'm gonna need a lot of water. I think it's great. The slickness is excellent. I have eaten some soap, not a big deal, not gonna die of food poisoning, I believe. So, first pass with the Razorine. Raw brass, first use of the Treet Durasharp blade. Hercules, this Hercules is also a fan of Razorine, and he recommended this blade because it works very good for him. And I ordered them to try it. I have already tried once, but not a sharp blade. I believe it's a nice pair of the Razorine. At this moment, the only blade that I really liked was the green Astra, the Astra Superior Platinum. And the problem with my growth is that when I stretch my skin and cut the hair too close to the surface, sometimes it tends to the hair get under the surface of the skin, and this leads to ingrown hairs. When I first got the Razorine, because I had so many or so much time to not get that, that I didn't get that, almost 2 months, I thought that I got my technique better. And that this isn't a problem to worry about, and I thought that this was a problem with my dry skin and the weather here. The weather changes. But it was just some ingrown hairs right here, and I have some more. I believe this is gonna sort it out sometime. I'm gonna apply some water and continue to apply second coat. When you properly soak this Omega brush in water, you get a very nice scrubby feeling, but a soft brush. You just don't have to press too hard, because it's gonna, you're gonna get some weird brass burn, and you don't want that. Had some soap in my set. The soap is performing very, very nice. And now for the second pass. I believe my technique is getting better every day with it. This slim profile gives you a very nice maneuverability. And of course, the first pass, when you have a lot of growth, is somehow rough, but the second is much better, much, much better. I'm gonna rinse up my face and feel for any stubble left. I'm gonna do a touch up on the mustache. Maybe I get irritation on this side of my face, because as you can see, this is clear as hell. It's because I'm using my left hand like this. And this is the first time that I am using it, and maybe I'm just pressing too hard or not get used to it very well. So this was an excellent save. Some redness under my nose. I'm sorry. This was an excellent save. My some redness under the nose. Not saving related. Some red spots here and there. But a nice save overall. I'm seeing no nicks, not anything. So I'm gonna rinse up my face, get back to you for the aftershave. So, in a minute. A splash of cold water is always great after a shave. So nice. And the slickness is very good with this Hercules. Because I had some skin problems, I'm using this. This is the Nivea Sensitive Cooling Aftershave Lotion with no alcohol in it. It gives you a nice cooling sensation, some very nice. Smooth skin. So this, and when this dries out and when it's starting to dissipate, it is very cooling for the skin, and I don't believe it contains any menthol, some oil, some peppermint oil, or just the dissipating, dissipation cools the face naturally. It's like splashing water all over your face. So today's soap was TFS Hercules. Amazing stuff at an amazing price, and a tribute to a fellow wet saver, whipped up with this monstrous Omega with so much lather left, so much. Let me do the Mike the Razor Rookie Karate Test Saving Soap. It fell down the sink, but has a nice lather picks. Very nice, creamy, cushiony lather, and my razor of choice is the Razorine Raw Brush with a Treet Durasharp Carbon Steel Double Edge Blade, and I finished it off with some Nivea Men Cooling Aftershave Lotion for sensitive skin, and probably I'm gonna use some Proraso White Ad Irritation Shaving Balm. So, thank you for sticking out, thank you for joining me in this amazing review of the TFS Hercules, and I wish you a nice day. So, until next time.